Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA tournament. Today's game is between the Butler Bulldogs and the Seton Hall Pirates. Ladies and gentlemen, the bracket. And there is the starting lineup for each team.
Everyone wants to be in the starting five, Gus.
And let's have a look at the keys to the game for these teams here today.
If they can get these things accomplished, they're going to have a good shot at the win today.
The Bulldogs control the tip, and the floor is underway. Now they work it around the perimeter. Jump shot.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
They may have him in some trouble here, Ryan.
What a great trap, Gus. The defense is getting after it.
And we'll get a change of possession. Offensively, they'll set up from the sideline. Shots up. And no! Can finish. A great trap initiated by the defense. The Pirates. And they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Thanks for joining us here on CBS Sports. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery. Looking for a good shot. Fired. No.
What a rebound. I own it.
On the right side. Jump shot. He can't get it to go. Give it here. McDermott receives the pass. He fires away, and he can't get them out. Powell receives the ball. Rises. Shots off.
Get out and fill.
McDermott handles the pass. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. Heat check time from long range. Can't connect from the three-point line. Nelson handles the feed. In the lane.
Got it!
Powell is known as a passer, scorer-type player.
You know, this guy can move the basketball and create his own opportunities. Really a tough guard, Gus.
Out on the left wing. Fired. Nice bucket. Takes the pass in the paint. Foul on the play. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Well, Bill, here is a player in his freshman year.
This year is going to be a big year for this young guy. If he's smart, he'll latch on to a few of the upperclassmen until he gets the hang of things.
He makes it. He got them both. We are at the 7-minute mark. The ball handler is in trouble. Full court pass.
And lays it in.
May be in some trouble. Second team foul. Sideline inbound. On the left side. He makes the block. On the outside. Rise and fire. The soft move. We are at the 6-minute mark. He's being trapped. Pushes it. Right, they've got him right where they want him. Can't elude the trap.
The young guy has some trouble with that trap.
The shot clock down to 10. In the paint. Off the mark. Goes up high with two hands. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Now they work it around the perimeter. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Out on the right wing. We're at the 5-minute mark. Nelson turns the ball over. Pushing in transition. First personal foul. Aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
How about the action so far, Coach? Some good postseason tournament action. I'm certain the people watching are enjoying this one. Neither team backing down at this point.
I'll tell you what makes the NCAA so special is the fact that it takes one bad night. One bad night, and your season is over.
It's going to be a shame that when the final horn sounds, one of these very competitive teams will be out, and their season will be over.
That trap could spell trouble. And he's fouled. He crashed in on the layup and gets the foul.
Boy, that's really sacrificing for the club. He knew he was going to get fouled, but he went strong to the tip.
Here's another solid junior build.
By the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's about leading by example and guiding the younger players on the team.
And we'll go to the free throw line. It's good. Pushes it. The trap's in place, Rap. Entry pass in the paint. Shots off.
Perfect.
A great trap initiated by the defense. Ball stripped. In the paint. He missed it.
What a rebound. It's mine.
They work it around the perimeter. He got it up and in. Looking for a good shot. Powell getting after it, saves it. Up and in. Ha ha! He's being trapped. Pushes it. The ball stripped. The Bulldogs in a hurry. A great trap initiated by the defense. They keep him under wraps.
Tried to beat it, but he couldn't, Gus.
We're at the 3-minute mark. Shots off. Pulls it down. Rejected. On the right side. It's a call for the foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Well, Bill, this young man's now in his second season of eligibility.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
The charity strike. That trap could spell trouble. And he's fouled. On the right side. Pull up jumper. Hits. Now looking to attack. We are at the 2-minute mark. Nice pass to the low block. Jump shot. No. Grabs the ball. They work the perimeter. Shots up. He can't get it to go. And that's a jam. This guy is a complete player in the post.
The big fella can face you up, play back to the basket. He's a good rebounder and solid on that defensive end.
Out on the wing. And we'll head back down to the other end. Let's take a moment and look at this slam again.
He's looking good. Strong to the goal. Send it in. Elevation.
One minute left on the game clock. In the post. Rejected. Out on the right wing. Looking for a good shot.
English on it.
Stay tuned for the road to the Final Four. And let's take a moment to look at some team stats for both sides here. Let's check in and take a look at how both sides are doing with the keys to the game. Second half of play, coach, NCAA tournament. Doesn't get much bigger than this. Who's going to fight to ensure that they move on to the next round? The answer, just a moment.
I'll tell you what, momentum is so important right now. One of the goals for either team should be to get on a little run, get a bit of separation, and then force the opponent to make plays and come from behind to win.
Dump it inside. Fire.
How about that, Gus?
May be in some trouble. On the right side. Jump shot. And he can't get them out. McDermott receives the pass. It's knocked out of there. Blocked. Powell receives the ball. And he lays it up and in. A terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Great block shot. On the right side. Around 8 minutes remaining. On the outside. He doesn't get the hoop. Baldwin handles the feed. Shots off.
Get out from Phil.
On the wing. Rise and fire. He can't get the bucket to fall. On the left side. Fires. Off the mark. Snatches the board. Out on the wing. Jump shot, and he hits it. 7 minutes left on the game clock. And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Shoots this well from the line, playing aggressive defense can come back to haunt you.
When a team shoots a high percentage from the line, it makes them that much harder to defend.
Sixes. A great trap initiated by the defense. It's stolen away. Here they go in transition. Call for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just got to know when to back off.
Two shots. No doubt about it. He got them both. Nelson handles the pass. He manages to keep it in. Ball's going to stay down here. Inbounds play on the baseline. Shot clock shows 10. They work the perimeter. Fires are called for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble.
A chance for two.
Great attack.
Makes it. It's good. We are at the 6-minute mark. He can't get the hoop to fall. Looking for a good shot.
It's good.
Tup it inside. Jump shot. And he misses the shot. On the left side. Buried. Timeout call. We'll get you back into the action right after this. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. We're at the 5-minute mark. On the right side. Fires. He missed it. Gets the board. In the post. Jump shot. No.
Push it.
On the outside. Dials up a long-range shot. The Bulldogs are having a tough time hitting from the floor, Coach.
They can't buy one, Gus.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the corner, but he misses his target. McDermott receives the ball. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Doesn't get much better than this in NCAA tournament basketball. A close first half. Second half has been much the same. And, Bill, I've got a hunch that it's going to come down to the final few possessions.
Hey, Gus, I think this is going right to the finish line. I think this game may come down to the last possession. These teams are competing and executing to a very high level. I mean, they're making every big shot, both of these clubs.
Inside.
The traps in place round. In the paint. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. 3 minutes left on the game clock. This one may go down to the final buzzer, Rad. Here we go.
In close games like this, Gus, offensive and defensive execution is very, very, very important.
He fires away, and he can't hit the shot. Powell with the ball. He shoots from the corner. The Pirates can't find the basket at all, Coach.
You know, they're really not taking advantage of their opportunities. No legs left, Gus.
They work the perimeter. Careless mistake there. Nelson receives the ball. Fires. Gets it to go. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. He doesn't get the hoop. Can finish. He's being trapped. Stolen. McDermott receives the pass. Jump shot. Buries it. May be in some trouble. Around a minute remaining. Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Rath. Taken away. Dump it inside. Call for the foul. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, guys. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
McDermott gets the pass.
Now they really have to foul in order to stop the clock, Gus. Some people dread this part of the game, Gus, when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Change of possession. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. Powell takes the pass. He throws up the shot. No. The senior. Foul. And that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
Tough team to foul because they shoot such a good percentage from the line.
When everyone on the floor can convert from the line, it makes this team very tough, especially down the stretch. The opposition is trying to foul.
One shot. No good. Grabs the rebound. And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. Nelson handles the pass. He lets it go.
Oh!
And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. Foul line.
Solid shooter.
Got it! Makes the shot. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. He shoots from long range. The shot won't fall. Well, Bill, sometimes statistics lie, but in NCAA tournament basketball, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, when you take a close look at this victory, it came down to execution. We say it all the time, but these guys did a terrific job of getting stops at the defensive end and scores at the offensive end.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for now. Tune in for more college basketball action on CBS Sports, brought to you by EA Sports. For Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson.